You are listening to the Starter Girls Podcast with Amy Lafitte
and Jennifer Loading.
And whether you're starting a project, starting a business, starting a brand, or starting a movement, we are here to talk about it. And I'm really excited. We are going to be talking with somebody who not only started a brand, a business, but a movement here today. But Jennifer, what are you excited about today?
Oh my gosh, I'm excited about a lot of things. Like I said in the earlier show, we are always excited, right? I will say this. This is our last day at the Venture X Campbell Center. We are moving on to bigger and better, and we're super excited. And like we did on our live, we're not going to say anything to you about what's happening yet, but we are going to do some amazing collaborations with a new group of people. We are super excited about that, so you guys are going to have to stay tuned to that. And watch out. We're going to do some fun stuff. We're excited.
Yes, it's so awesome. And I am excited here to talk about our guest. And so I'm actually going to do it from her viewpoint. So this is Kaylee's story. So she says, my pursuit of fulfillment began back in college in 2009 when I realized how much I enjoyed giving and sharing to make people feel a sense of great meaning in each moment. My love for coffee has grown over the years, and my entrepreneurial spirit has been contemplating how I was going to bring meaning to people as a business. Coffee is a universal language that brings people together just like love. Whether it's enjoyed on a cold, snowy morning in a cabin on the mountains, or whether it's sipping during social hour with good friends or a new stranger. So I'm really excited to bring on the fabulous Kaylee Ocampo. She started the LYMI Coffee brand, and I can't wait just to have you on here today, lady.
Yes, thank you guys so much for having me. I'm really, really excited.
Awesome. I love it. We always start with a little bit of small talk, although I think Jennifer is going to ask the questions.
Oh, we can with our rapid fire. Yes. Sounds like a good idea. All right, so Kaylee, are you a morning or a night person?
I love to be a morning person, but right now I'm in between. So I swap around. Like, I have clients that pull me in different directions. I have my business that needs things at different odd hours. So whenever the creative flow is happening, that's where I live.
That's all right. It's all good. Yeah. All right. Cat or dog person?
Dog. Oh my gosh. Their love is just undeniable. It's so beautiful. Dogs.
Mm. Love it. Love it. And what would you say is your favorite food?
It's so cliche. Pizza. Pizza. Yes, actually, I like Amy's pizza specifically.
My son eats Amy's pizza on a weekly basis.
Yes,
like on a weekly basis. Yeah. Seriously, weekly basis. I have to buy that. Which one do you get?
I get the one with pepperoni or just cheese, and I chop up some chicken that I make and throw that on there as well.
He does the margarita.
Ooh. Extra.
That's his thing every week. That's on my shopping list every week. I just get the Amy's, and I just know what it is. It's the margarita pizza.
It just feels better. It feels lighter afterwards, so it's not as sinful.
Because if I'm going to say pizza, like, I don't ever eat pizza unless I make a low-carb pizza. Like, I don't know when's the last time I've had, like, regular pizza.
Yeah.
But if I was going to say pizza, I'd be like, give me, like, some gourmet, like really bad for you pizza.
Worst.
Like the good stuff. Like, when we were growing up, they had, like, Godfather's pizza. You know, oh, my gosh, Godfather pizza. You remember that?
Yes.
And it was, like, so awfully good.
Yep. I just actually just started eating Urban Crust pizza.
Oh, like, I love
from the frozen
this.
Aisle.
Yes. Yeah. That's what
so
I get if I get it.
Hearty. It's, like, chicken, sausage, pepperoni, uncured bacon, or uncured pepperoni. So good.
Apparently, we might all be hungry right now.
Yeah. It's noon.
Yeah. We got into food conversation. Very quickly.
Here we go. We'll get it back onto business.
That's right.
So, okay. So, Kaylee, tell everybody what you do and really, like, what makes you unique. We've already kind of talked about it a little bit, but would love to know more.
Yeah. So, I started LYMI Coffee, which is a community-based company. I always knew that I wanted something to call my own because I love building brands and building a business, and I've done that for a majority of my adult life. So it was time for me to do something of my own, but it had to be meaningful. And so, just like you said, coffee is a universal language that brings people together. And it's something that is the catalyst that people have conversations around, right? It's actually the second world's largest traded commodity. You know, I think you guys are familiar with that. Everyone's heard that. But that has some meaning behind it. And so it was really important for me to have something that is shared among people so that we can have the right conversations in the right atmosphere. And not only that, but the caffeine, and everyone relies on that, or a lot of people do. It really brings that life to you when you take those first sips. So it's euphoric. I love it.
That's nice.
You can't go wrong with coffee. I would agree with you on that.
Yeah. I know. Even though you're not a big coffee girl, I know.
Yeah, I'm not a coffee drinker, but I'm not stupid. I mean, I know.
I wasn't before. Yeah. I was not before. And then I had to start getting up earlier. And you know, I like to keep my appetite clean. And then I was like, I don't want coffee. But then I learned gourmet coffee is a whole nother level. Mm-hmm. And that's what I have. So
yeah. Well, my middle child, the other day I was on I don't know what they do. They were doing Skype or Zoom or what we were doing. But my son was on a call with her. And she's like, Mom, guess what? I love coffee. And I'm like, okay. Yeah. So do you drink it black? What do you put in there? This is my middle child who's off of college now. This is her first year at Southern Arkansas. Yeah. And I don't even know, like, she never drank coffee, like, ever. And all of a sudden they developed this, like, coffee habit.
Yep. Yeah, and that's kind of how it happened for me. My roommates introduced really good coffee to me, and it was such a great experience. We lived on the beach, and it was a beautiful Saturday morning in California, and so we would just share these conversations and have really good coffee, and the smell and the meaning behind everything, just that's when I was like, I love coffee. Yeah. I love this.
Right. All right, awesome. Kaylee, was there a childhood experience that impacted who you are today?
Absolutely. So I actually played softball my entire life since I was 4 years old. And being able to go out and do something that you're extremely passionate about and that you love and show up and do your absolute best to perform, like getting those results after that, that was very special to me, and learning the discipline behind that and what it means to actually be passionate about something, no matter the result, right? Like if you lost or if you won, but you know you put your heart into it, and then learning where you can grow, where you need to tweak things to become better and stronger and faster. So that was a huge impact for me, being able to play from 4 to 18 and then after in an adult league, absolutely shaped everything that I am today.
That's awesome. We have another athlete here.
I know.
I love that. They see the common thread between entrepreneurial spirit and athleticism.
Absolutely.
Right?
Mindset.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely.
Big. It's really big. So kind of going in that same vein, when you're going after like a goal or a project, what is your experience, your schedule, your thought process, your mindset? What does that look like?
My mindset starts at the end result. I always work from within. What is the feeling that I want to experience behind whatever it is that I'm after? Whether it's in personal relationships, friendships, business goals, there's a certain experience that I want to feel. I'm a very big feelings person. So that's my primary goal every single time. And I look ahead at what that is, what that goal is, and then I envision it and I really embody it and feel it. And then I look at where I'm at right now, and then I just start taking the steps to towards that with whatever's in alignment and whatever's coming in front of me. So I don't like to focus on like the how or too much. I do like to have processes in place, but really it's the end result that keeps me going.
It's beautiful. I love it.
I love it too. I would agree with that 100%.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. With that. Yeah, absolutely. Because you don't always know how the things are going to take place. Sometimes you just have to go with the flow. And if you're so fixated on every minute thing, I mean, a couple of things are going to happen. One, they may not go as you planned, but also you're going to get overwhelmed looking at it, you know? And I think that's why a lot of people start things and they don't finish, because they start planning so much.
Yeah.
They like start looking at all the hows and they don't see the hows happening. And so they get discouraged. And then that gets back to our plan B. There's always another plan.
Yes. Yeah. And I like that you said starting also with the feeling, because, you know, I didn't know that towards the beginning of my life. And finally hearing that in, you know, like personal development or whatever, that was really big, because there's times where you make decisions to go after a goal based on, I want this feeling. And then you realize I could get that feeling a whole bunch of other ways. And you know, if you want that end result, that's fine, you know, but if it's just really that you want the feeling, there's other ways to go about that that maybe aren't so grandiose, aren't so time consuming, so that's really, I think that's really powerful.
Yeah. And another piece of it is fearlessness. Like a lot of people get stuck because of fear, right? Mm-hmm. Everything revolves around that, starts there. And being able to see the end and have a focus on that allows you to get over fear a lot easier. It does take work and a conscious effort, but being able to be fearless and step into the unknown and try things and not afraid to fail.
Yeah. So. That's awesome.
Yeah.
100%.
Yeah.
It's good, Kaylee. I was going to call you the other night. And got it.
No, Kaylee from Cali.
That's right.
I love that.
That's a good way to remember it. We'll get it right. No, I think that's good. I think that what she said, that's awesome. So, yeah.
Yeah.
Having fear is the reason that most people stop doing what they're doing. So, all right. So, what's the hardest thing you've ever had to overcome?
Okay. I prepared myself for this.
Oh, I love it. This is my favorite question because I want to know is how did you get where you're at? What'd you do?
Yeah. So the biggest challenge that I've had to overcome that I think many people at some point in their life have to overcome is the feeling of loss and heartbreak. So for me personally, it was relationships. Because once you experience heartbreak and loss, that, and it can be a death or it could be the relationship ending with someone that you love. Everything is off kilter. You can't trust your mind. You can't trust your heart. You can't trust your intuition. You can't trust the people around you. You're in such a chaotic state and everything's swirling, right? And so to have a grasp on any one thing is really difficult in that moment. So that's very challenging, and that's something that I've had to overcome twice in my life, and one of them is recent. So it's fresh.
Yeah,
yeah. But this is part of the process of just being able to breathe, and all the work that you've ever done up until that point is so important because now you're taking those tools and you're like, okay, the only thing I can rely on is what I know works. Mm-hmm. Now I just have to stay focused on implementing that tool, utilizing that tool that I've learned and needed and I've had in the back pocket for this whole time. So relying on the tools is so important in those times.
Absolutely. Wow. That sounds like an Olympian that we were talking to.
Adding a tool to the tool belt.
I'm kind of an emotional Olympian.
Well, that's okay. You're probably passionate about the things you do, you know? And I always talk about that. I think you have to take the good with the bad because even if you're passionate about the bad things, you're probably really passionate about the good things too. So, you take it all. That's what I always say about me. You take the good with the bad. It is what it is. I'm passionate about everything, good or bad.
Yeah, and you can't be afraid to put your whole heart out there. Mm-hmm. You just can't.
100%. Mm-hmm. 100%. Yeah. I agree.
And that was so beautiful, your poetic way of explaining heartbreak. So thank you I love hearing that from an emotional person. That's that should be written on paper somewhere. That's really beautiful.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
That is awesome.
Oh, is it my turn?
It is, but I keep having a question I want to ask about this coffee.
Do. Okay,
really
let's
quick.
Talk about the coffee.
I want to talk about this coffee really quick because our people are like, okay, so what's this coffee? What makes it different about everybody else's coffee?
Yes.
Right? So tell us about this coffee really quick so our listeners know what is special about this stuff.
Yes, so it was important to me to have a quality of life, but also quality product, right? So I searched high and low for a really premium quality coffee that's clean. So mine in particular is organic and direct trade and has a very silky finish and very low acidity. Mm-hmm. It is also naturally extra caffeinated because of the type of beans. So it's a AA Robusta blend with Brazilian beans. So starting from the farmers and the way that they're harvesting these beans and the way that that exchange is occurring between the farmers and the organization that my roaster works with, all the way to the actual roaster who I have had a great rapport with and relationship with, they put so much care into every single step. So that actually conveys through each cup and each sip. But not to mention just the taste and the quality profile of the actual coffee is really, really good.
I love that. Thanks for sharing that.
Yeah.
Because we were talking about this coffee, and I'm like, you got to tell us about what is this, especially if it is the second traded most commodity, right? We're talking coffee. We need to talk about it.
Yeah.
A lot of people drink it. So thank you for sharing that with us.
Yeah, definitely.
I know. I think it's really interesting. High vibe and, all the.
Yep. It's called High Vibe for all the positivity, all the high vibes in life, but also
like high vibes.
Extra caffeine.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Exactly. So. And we talked about LYMI Coffee, but I don't think you've ever told people what that stands for.
So LYMI stands for, it's LYMI. I use the acronym LYMI for Love You Mean It. That is the name of my company, Love You Mean It. And again, the whole premise and base of my company is bringing community together to be able to share encouragement, love, and that support that everyone needs in a community.
That's awesome. I love it.
I love that.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Well, and with all your different experiences, who would you say is your biggest influence, or do you have a couple of influences?
That's a good one. And there are a few people, there are a few people along the way of my life. I would say my softball coach, one of them, who was really dedicated to helping me get those scholarship offers, which I declined at the end of the day. He was very impactful there, teaching me that process of determination. And then currently, I would say on Instagram, Manifestation Babe. If you are not following her already, huge shout out to her. I've witnessed that woman in the last 4 years when I first discovered her. I've witnessed her grow from zero to a multimillionaire.
Wow.
And she's 27.
Wow.
Yes. I mean, she her essence is just so beautiful, and she has accomplished so much. Literally anything she's put her mind to, she's accomplished. And it's just so beautiful to watch. And she's so open, vulnerable, honest, and transparent. And just so connected. Mm-hmm. So she's one of my biggest influences behind a lot of my mindset, really. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's really awesome.
It is.
I love it. I know, it's so cool when you can now have influences that are online that don't even necessarily know you.
Mm-hmm.
I love just the world that we're in right now with all the information and all the different people we can pull from. It's pretty cool.
Yes. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. So I want to ask you a question. What have you learned in your journey that can help other people that are maybe pursuing a journey? Maybe they're starting something or they're in the middle of something.
I would say one thing that I've learned is being able to believe in yourself first and believe your vision. So be able to see it and actually believe it to your core is the first step in getting anywhere with anything. If you don't first believe it and see it, you can't take those next steps. So being able to believe that to the core is one of the biggest things that I would, you know, tell anyone to do first.
Yeah. And you got to believe it more than anybody else,
mm-hmm.
you know, because the thing with that is if you're halfway committed to your vision, nobody else is committed with you.
No.
Right?
Yeah.
So you got to be like, you almost have to be obnoxious with it. Like, you got to almost be like, I am so fired up about this inside that I don't care what anybody else thinks. Yep. I'm going to make it happen.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right?
Yep, exactly. And then you might have to create your own path, but take that path unknown. Like, everyone's creating every single day. Why can't you?
Exactly.
So,
I think that's awesome.
And find your people that want to be a part of that. You know, that's, I think there's power in that too, when you find your people that believe in your vision with you and that can rally behind you.
That's so important. You know? You have to weed out the naysayers. You have to weed out anyone who just can't visualize what you see. That's okay. Mm-hmm. No one is going to be able to see it the way you see it.
Yeah.
But what you can do is just weed them out. You have to be able, you have to be strong enough to do that.
Mm.
It's important.
I agree.
It's really good. Yeah.
And I have to say something. You have, like, beautiful eyes. Like, eyes are just like...
Oh, that's funny. You must have been reading my mind, because I was saying the same thing as your eyes are, like, piercing me. With, I know. And they're blue.
Well, and I know. And you've got these beautiful big brown eyes. They remind me of my oldest daughter. Aww. Like, they're just beautiful and brown. I'm like, I'm looking at her eyes. I'm like... See these just
they're
beautiful
captivated.
Eyes.
No.
Yeah, Jennifer has those ice blue captivating eyes.
Got like piercing
I have,
eyes.
I can see through your soul. Like, I tell people all the time. People are like, your eyes.
Tell me what's in there. I don't know what's in there sometimes.
You're going to do great things.
Oh my gosh. Thank you.
Actually, I want to touch on that a little bit about all the greatness that has come out of you, because you were living in California.
Uh-huh.
You've moved to Texas in the last 2 years. In the process, you started this company. Like, kind of tell people, because again, like, I'm thinking, I mean, and I know also Leni, she just moved from California as well. And so, and I was just at an event this last Saturday for her, for a nonprofit, and I was blown away by the amount of people that she had in that room. She probably had 50 people in the room, and everybody's like, oh, she's my friend. And I was like, she's been here 2 months. Like,
that's awesome.
I think it's even happened. So I'm really impressed sometimes, like, when people come here, because I mean, it's really easy to be like, oh, it's going to take me 6 months to even get my bearings. And I don't think either one of you guys did that. So, like, tell everybody a little bit about your journey.
Yes. So I came at a really good time. I had just turned 30. And I was leaving the career that I once had, that for 7 years I was working in philanthropy consulting and connecting celebrities with charities around the world and really helping build that business. And it was a lot of fun, a lot of great experience, but I was looking for that next opportunity to grow. So the timing was really good, because I was transitioning out of that and turning 30, and I was I was having a great life, but ready for the next challenge. And so I really had to have that open mindset. And when I came out here, I was so ready to just paint this blank canvas, and I saw nothing but opportunity, because it's new people, new experiences, new sites, new environment, new everything. Mm-hmm. And that is where you grow the most. And that's where, you know, growth happens. It really does. And so, came out here, got a corporate job, hated it so much, and I never had worked corporate before, so got what I needed from that, the experience of what structure really is, and when it's against your actual creativity, and so did well there, left the company after 8 months, and took a huge leap of faith on what it was I was after, which was more meaning, right, and more mm-hmm. creativity, and so I left to go work for a e-commerce store, and I learned a little bit there, but I wasn't really able to expand on that. So then that's when I just decided, like, okay, I came out here, I got my bearings, I kind of got a lay for the land and understand what Texas means and what business is like out here. And now I'm ready to really pursue some more and connect and start networking and meeting a lot more people, and not just focused on work. So that's when I opened myself up to the universe, and that day, I think it was, or the very next day, is when I met someone, Megan McGee, who works with Icarus Productions. She's just the amazing person, and she started a conversation with me at a coffee shop, and that's why I love coffee, right? Like, the community is there, and so she started this conversation with me, and we just took it from there, exchanged phone numbers, and it was such a brief conversation, too, and then she's like, well, we're having a networking meeting next week. So I was like, yes, this is perfect. This is exactly what I needed. Like, I don't even know where to start. And she just pops into my life.
Wow.
And then I go to this networking meeting, and I met who my client is today. And I've worked with them for over a year now. And so much has come from that. So I just kept doing and doing and giving and giving. And that's always been the premise of everything, is I want to give. Where can I provide the most value? And I just do whatever I need to do in that area. So that's what happened. And then once I felt comfortable enough, I was like, all right, let's start my company. And I figured out it's going to be coffee. Let's go. And I just started putting all the pieces together from there.
That's a great story.
Thank you.
I love that. I think that's cool, because you had this inspired idea that came about, you know, in this moment. And that's what it's about. Yeah. You know what I mean? That's what it's about. Because when you're trying to figure something out, I always find that when you're trying to think about things, they don't necessarily fall into place. But it's in those moments when you're not really thinking, the inspired action comes about. And then you have to kind of go on that gut. Like, you've got that idea. Especially, I tell people all the time that if it's coming back to you more than once, you need to do something on that. Like, check that. Like, you need to do something. Some people will be thinking about something for a long time, and that conversation will keep coming up, and they keep putting it back down. And I'm like, what are you doing? Take that and run.
Yeah.
It's like a clear sign.
It is. It is. But also, it's a lot of timing. Yeah. Like, I sat on the idea of knowing I wanted to have a business for about 4 or 5 years, probably like 5 or 6 years, actually.
Yeah.
And for years, I knew that, but I had to go through so many different experiences and growth opportunities to then be like, oh, this is it. And the timing just aligned, and I had networked myself like crazy. And then, you know, now I'm ready. And that's when I was able to just confidently move forward with that idea.
Mm-hmm. Well, and I think, too, you put yourself in the right place, because you're talking about timing. Yes, it is timing, because I think you could go, you could sit back in your house every day and say, I want to be an entrepreneur. And nothing happens. Yeah. Right? But you go out there and you're putting yourself in these places. And so when things come to you, that's when inspired action comes. So you're thinking of these things. It is timing, but you have to be proactive.
Exactly.
You can't be having the timing and just sitting, and you need to do that.
No.
You obviously didn't do that. That's why the idea came about.
And it's so important to, not every opportunity is going to be the right opportunity.
Right.
And I learned that a long time ago. Mm-hmm. And so when I came out here, that's why I left the corporate world, because I'm like, this is not it, because I'm not in alignment with what my end goal is for myself.
Yeah.
So I need to leave this space, and then I go on to the next. But I took what I needed from there. So you have to always choose the things that are in alignment, and you won't know if they are for sure right off the bat until you actually go step into that role, and then you can move from there. Mm-hmm. So that's super important, is also taking those steps that are in alignment and not being afraid that if it's not, well, if it's not, okay, get it out of your way.
Yeah. So, and I think giving, when you talked about the giving, I think that's when we were talking about manifesting and everything, I think that's a really big piece. Like, when you're, because I feel like you get actually more opportunities sometimes when you're not working for it, right? Like if you aren't getting paid for it, you're going to get, I mean, like I remember like I wanted to be a doctor and I told the hospital, I'm like, I'll come and volunteer. And I was blown away. Like I could walk into any wing. They would let me go anywhere I wanted. I had head nurses showing me how to do the craft. Like, I mean, like crazy stuff that you, like if you were like, hey, I want to work here, you know, for even $15 an hour, $12 an hour, I'm not going to get those opportunities. So I found like volunteering or giving of your time is really where you start to open up some places and open up just more experiences that you may not necessarily have access to. I know Alini even came to Jennifer and said, hey, I'm new to the area. I want to learn some different things. I will volunteer my time. I will be here for free. I will just help you get this project started. And, and, you know, great things always happen from, you know, just being willing to give first.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Start with the value add and everything will, everything else will fall into place.
Yeah. So. I love it.
Yeah. So awesome.
All right, you're amazing.
I know.
All right. So if you could be any superhero or character, who would you choose?
Oh my gosh, it is going to be Angelina Jolie from Salt. Or Mr. and Mrs. Smith's like the same character,
right? Totally.
She's so like subtly classy, sexy, chic.
Yes.
And then she's so badass.
Yeah. So skillful. I would agree.
That's my character. That is my alter ego.
I could totally see you like this.
Yeah.
Wait, aren't you taking like some sort of like self-defense classes or something? Was that you that posted that on Facebook?
It was me. I put it out there. I was like, all right, it's time I take action on this character I'm trying to build, this alter ego.
I like it.
So I do. I actually need to follow up with a couple people on that who are like, yeah, I'll take you shooting, and you know there's some skills training.
So cool.
I was trying to like get back into the gym so I could prepare myself for this. I'm ready.
Oh my goodness,
that's so awesome.
Mine is and roll.
I know, right?
There you go.
Mine is Lara Croft Tomb Raider, so we're totally.
Oh my gosh,
I want the Indiana Jones.
I can see it. Yep,
that's so fun. So tell our viewers, if they want to get in contact with you, your company, all that, what are the best ways for people to reach out to you?
So everything is LYMI Coffee on social media, Instagram, Facebook, at LYMI Coffee. So LYMICoffee.com. And also, I have a series, Coffee with Kaylee, for more of these types of conversations and the community aspect of the business. LYMICoffee.com/itsmisskaylee. ITSMSKALI.
I like it. She's so cute.
I love it.
She's so cute with her beautiful brown eyes.
Awesome.
All right. So this has been amazing. Thank you. We appreciate you. And you did an amazing job.
Thank you so much, you ladies. Yeah. Oh, so happy to be here.
So what we want to say to our listeners is, if you enjoy our podcast, please be sure you give us a rating on both iTunes and Facebook, because we cannot do this without you. And we do want to put in a plug again that our event is coming up on April 4th. Decisions are magical. You want to be sure to get your ticket for that. We've got the amazing Brianna Reyes coming to speak. She is a former 100 Top American Idol finalist, and we are super, super excited about that. And with that, I think it's time to wrap up with our mantra.
That's right.
All right. So it's a great day to be brave. You might as well start now. You have the power to change your circumstances any day you decide. Let today be that day. Rise up. Be amazing. Be you. Do you. All right, you guys, take care. Be safe and be kind to one another. We'll see you next time.
Bye-bye.